And the last speaker for today's event, Mr. Ravi Rajshekar. He recently received his Masters of Strategic Foresight from Swinburne University of Technology, Melbourne. He finished his BE from Andhra University College of Engineering and his MTech from IIT Kharagpur. He's interested in ICT industry from the past 20 years, and he has recently started a social enterprise called Swan Foresight Private Limited with an aim to design sustainable and ethical future. He will talk about how to design your future. So please welcome Mr. Rajasekhar.
Okay. I know that I have very less time. So in the interest of time, I'm not going to talk about myself. I'm going to talk about yourselves. So thanks for inviting me for this session. Quickly, there is some paper in front of you. If you want to have a look at that paper and answer to that, that would be great as I get into the presentation.
Sorry.
That's okay. So I will not. So when we think about the future, we always think about what we are thinking ahead. So we have to think about two other things. That is about the past and also what we are in present right now. What happened?
Past
which has gone to past. Okay, the agenda, I am not going to talk about much of it. We will talk about imagination as I am speaking. It's on the slide already. The next viewer is watching the slide. And an example of career paths, which will come to some of the previous speakers. And the third point, follow game. We'll try to do a little bit of game with, along with the paper that you have got as feature work scale there in front of your seats. And we will have fourth slide, the fourth point, I'm not going to talk about myself today in the interest of time. And the last one is, what's in it for me on Monday? Expecting that you are taking rest in the weekend. So yeah, quickly on this slide, everybody wants to grow up in the career, and we think of steps, and we think in the future point of it. Immediately what we think is, what is ahead of me? That's the chessboard. What are my challenges? How am I going to take care of those challenges? That's what we think about it. It's within 3 to 4 years of time. How do I settle down here? Or how do I settle down in any part of the world after my PhD? Then comes a little bit of mountain there. As you can see, there's a mountain. Oh, where would I land up in 10 to 15 years? What would I be doing in 10 to 15 years? Then comes the star. That is what is towards the end of my professional life or active life, around 65 age. Where would I land? Would I be a Nobel laureate? I'm just thinking, setting the example there. So that's what this is what we are thinking about. So we have to have that thought in our mind. We will think about it also in that perspective. Yeah. Quickly, I want to show how the career and jobs used to be, as Yogendra and Bala have told already in the past. So I have taken an example of this person, David Thodey. He joined as an engineer in Telstra maybe 30, 40 years back, and he has become a CEO in 2011 or 12 time. And after that, he is now head of CSIRO also. Yeah. Yes, he is the head of CSIRO and the government positions. It has taken a lifetime for him to reach that position. Let's think about this person. This person in the middle age, he's already one of the CEO for one of the greatest companies, Google, Mr. Pichai. Then think about this person. He's already at the age of 30, 35, he has become a social entrepreneur. His company has crossed a lot. So I brought this point because the way that happened in the past is not the way it is going to be. And it is, I will change the word career. I want you to think about careers. I want you to think about not jobs. I want you to think about paid work. As Mr. Vasishta mentioned, his job changed every 2 years, even in the same field. So our jobs no more going to be the jobs. It is going to be paid work for our livelihood or for our passion. These are the two things we are going to work on. Paid work, that's what we are thinking about. Yeah, that's just something. So, before getting into the game, I want you to confirm that you have filled that future hope scale that I have given. It has got very quick questions, 8 questions for you. And I'm sure where your agency is, where your pathway is, and where your hope score is. If you are more than 24, I'm sure you would have been very high agency, high power people, and you are having high hopes. And please note down, if you have got less than 18 or low or moderate, it doesn't mean that you are very bad. At certain point of time in our life, we are very bad. Maybe Einstein, who has been all across, I don't think Einstein also failed in maths in his childhood. So we are all in different stages at different point of time. We have different agencies, different pathways, and different hope. Having that in mind, this game, please sitting, before getting into the game, I want to acknowledge these two people. It's on the name of the person, Mr. Fred Pollack. He's a Jew and he lived in the Second World War in concentration camps, and he survived. Later on, he did his so much of documentation he did on cultures and how it's done. Based on that, Dr. Peter Hayward, who is the professor in who was a professor in Finborn University and happened to be taking classes from this eminent person, he designed this game. And the interesting thing of this game is, you need to think about 4 quadrants, obviously, and one parameter to be measured is what sort of hope you have coming out of the future hope scale. Are you thinking the world is going to be better? Are you thinking that you are going to be better, you know, and you are going to perform better? Are you thinking bad or pessimism, optimism versus pessimism? The other cycle is essence versus influence. How much influence you can create to this world, to yourself, and you have control of yourself, you have control of the world around you. And that's where, if you are thinking that world is going to be better and the things near around you are going to be better, you are going to get a job or you are going to get work and you are sure about what's happening in your world and you can influence that, you are a contributor or a creator. So you need to think where exactly you are standing there. It's a game actually, it's a game is supposed to be all of us standing in this line and moving around the coordinates and feel like where exactly am I standing today. So since we can't move around this hall, think about which quadrant you belong to. And if you are you know that world is going to be better, but you are a little bit passive in doing things, you are not leading things, then you will be an active adapter because you are looking at the trends. You may not be trendsetter, you are trend follower and quick adapter to those things. And next one is, you think that it's going to be worse. You find the problems in the world. Yeah, it is not bad. When you find the problems, you know where the opportunities are. And you want to take care of those opportunities. I am thinking that all the people who have come to PhD, to do PhD, are in these right side quadrants. Either they are thinking that the world can be better and they are going to be the contributor to it, or they think that they can solve some problems of this world and they will be leading the problems of the world. I'm not thinking about the last one. And once again, there is nothing bad in going to be in this last quadrant. If you think in this quadrant, yeah, let's get into that out of the quadrant and try to be in another quadrant there. What could I do with that one? So it's a game. And when towards the end of the game, once people stand in those quadrants, people will exchange the ideas why they stood in that particular place, in that particular quadrant. It will be, some people will be in the middle of the quadrants with all of them together. So why they think that they are in the middle? They think that they are all across the floor. They are in this quadrant 0-0. Why they are there? So it's a little bit of thinking game, how do we do it and exchange the ideas. That's where we will know each other what they are thinking. And the more clearing out things happen out of your mind, the more new thoughts will come into the picture. It's unlearning the learning also. Okay, I don't want to spend much time on that game because we have the time and because of the logistics on this room, in this room. I'm skipping this. Next, what I want to do is there will be another paper set, 2 pages on, in front of you. Let's take this. This is what the last item, that is what is in it for me on Monday. So as a part of this, I requested you to fill the age, which age you belong to. Do you mind if you have copies, you can give it to them too. It matters them too. I don't want them to be sitting idle. And the second question, how many lives you want to live? You are not just a PhD student, sorry. You also have Yes. And yeah, start writing the goals, and then we'll think about what is the immediate goal that you have. Don't think anything, but quickly write down some goals for us. For yourself, not for us. I'll give a minute on this, then we will do the second sheet. All three goals very quickly. Anybody wants any extra time? I am going to enter the next step, which is now go to the third page, which is the this references. Please go through the references. I'll just walk through what it is there. In the first one, it says, we think about probably I am going to do this in my next 3-4 years. But you may not know, something might happen and you have to think about other things. Plausible futures, possible futures, all different kinds of futures. That thing is actually, it's a cone, futures cone. So in that futures cone, probable means immediately what I am going to do. I know I am sure about it, then goes on around it. That's why the plausible and possible, all these things have come. And we never think about the wild cards. So suddenly somebody comes, a friend comes and says that if Mr. Vasishta comes and says that, Dr. Vasishta comes and says to me, I have 200,000, let me start a company. That's a great thing for me, isn't it? Suddenly comes and tells that he can lend his human resources. So that's a great thing, it's a wild card entry for me. So we can't think of, these are positive things. I am sure there will be negative wild card entries in our lives. So those are the wild card entries, we have to think about it when we are filling the rest, the second page. And another important thing I want to bring to you is the personal domains. We always think about PhD or the study or the field, engineering field or information technology field. In the back of our mind, we have family, we have our financial status, we have our health. All of this matters a lot. Somebody has mentioned well-being and somebody has mentioned that Kobe has mentioned few points. Please note down those points. This is that domain that we are talking about. And quickly think about what would be the strength. Suddenly somebody asks you, It's not about that strength. Knowing the strength and how we are utilizing the strength is also what we need. And what is the area of improvement that we are working on. Not that we know that, what is that we are working on, how fast we are coping up on that. So whenever somebody asks for spot or anything, don't worry about the strength and weakness. Think about how you are utilizing our strengths and how we are improving in our areas of improvement. And passions. And examples of passion, I have given a couple of examples. And curiosities, couple of examples I have given. Now with these couple of examples, I want you to go back and fill out the passion, curiosity, and in the second sheet, the questions I have asked for. Energy sector is not the life. Because majority of the speakers are from energy sector. And if one of my subjects is innovation, something to do with energy sector, and first time I learnt about energy, a definition. It is not about water, power or electricity. It is the energy with which I am speaking, energy with which I am walking. Whatever I am converting and moving the finger, everything is energy. And we store energy in our fridges. We store energy in our pantries. So remember that energy is not that electricity energy, water energy. Everything is an energy. It's thousands of years of evolution is there for energy. And we are struggling for that energy. Okay. Passion, curiosity. Passion is something you know, you want to do it. And curiosity is something that you want to know, but you could not find time. And at one point of time, you want to do it. And what personal values you belong to, you vouch for. You are interested in what personal values. Truthfulness, honesty, or commitment to the work that you are going to do. Family values. You want to help friends. At any cost, I will be there, my friends and family. That's what you are thinking. Financial year. Or word of mouth, anything that you want to do. With these things in mind, I want you to rewrite the goals. And rest of the things, you can play other sheet. You can work it out at your home. And the more you work in the weekend, the more clear you are on Monday. So write down the goals here. Before you depart, rewrite the goals. It may not be the goals that the goals you have started with. They may not be the goals that you are really interested in and passionate about, curious about, and you want to be remembered by the rest of your team or friends, family, and the world.
Anyone from the audience would like to ask some questions? Are there?
Yes, ma'am.